So today I've been sick, but the show must go on, Copycat Friday must go on, because we've been working on something pretty amazing. It's Jordy here for CineCam.net, and let's start with a big thank you to Janik and Lorenzo, who have been shooting and editing this entire project. I'm only doing this part right here because I've been pretty darn sick. Today we'll be recreating the trailer of Atlanta Season 2. And honestly, I haven't seen the series yet, but from what I've read online, I should start watching this immediately. In the trailer, you see these amazing transitions where the camera rolls into and back out of the ground. That alone is not so hard, we actually did a video about that a while back, but what makes this so interesting is that we also have a person rolling with the camera. And this makes it a lot more complex, and we've been looking for the easiest way to recreate this.
Lorenzo, what's that groovy music?
Ah, yeah.
Woo, let's dance.
Now while I'm sitting here at home, Janik and Lorenzo can dance to the awesome music that Premium Beat have provided to us. It's a music library where you can find premium songs and loop sets for any commercial project. You can even use one song in multiple projects without having to purchase it again. Now Premium Beat have put up a special playlist for this episode, which you can find by clicking in the first link in the description below.
On the show, they did the effect with a green screen, so that's why we're gonna use a green screen. We already built one, and the important thing with a green screen is that you have two lighting zones. One for the green screen, like you can see, and one lighting zone for your subject. And that's because we don't want to cast shadows on the green screen. But the lighting for your subject is also really important, because you gotta match it with your background.
And the background is then shot elsewhere. Janik and Lorenzo just drove around looking for interesting spots. It would be better if the sun would shine, but the weather was unfortunately pretty bad. Now you want to find a way to rotate your camera here. We first tried it with a monopod, but that didn't came out right. The camera was shaking too much. We needed two legs to rotate the camera on. So we used our Mi Video tripod, which allows us to detach one leg. But you can also find other ways to only extend two of the three legs of any tripod. This was a lot better and allowed us to move the camera in a perfect arc. Every shot had to be empty, and you could already shoot it out of focus because we'll have the subject stand closer to the lens. Now if you forgot about this, then no worries, you can always add some blurriness in post-production. What we did do was also make a shot of our subject standing in that same frame. Well, let's use this, but it's a good reference to see how the lighting should be recreated in the studio.
So we did our location shots, let's go back to the studio.
Now your talent can sit on his knees as we'll be making a medium shot, and that will make it easier for Lorenzo to lay down, come up and fall back down. The lighting does have to change here, so what Janik did was holding an extended light above Lorenzo, and as Lorenzo makes his movement, Janik would walk with the light over him. So instead of moving the camera, we moved the light, giving the same impression. And most of the shots were pretty flat because of the bad weather, so for those clips we added a soft dome to our Stella light. The night background had a street light on top, so there we could attach a Fresnel mount to the fixture and added an orange filter to it to mimic that street light.
Without Jordy here, I'm feeling quite blues. But with this Premium Beat playlist, I'm feeling quite funky. Oh. Yeah. This Premium Beat playlist is specially made for this video. You can choose out of 10 soulful songs to funk up your video. Never miss a beat with Premium Beat.
The post-production process is fairly simple. You can already put your background on the bottom and the green screenshot on top of that. First, you want to mask out your subject and remove the green using an ultra key effect. Now you can try to match the movement of your subject to the background, and you might want to enable time remapping for that clip to speed up the first and last parts. This could take some time to readjust until you got it right. When your subject lays close to the ground, there should be a shadow, and one way to create that is by adding a new black color mat underneath your subject clip. Draw a mask in the shape of a person around it and feather it a bunch. You also want to lower the opacity so that the shadow is subtle. Next, I would move the anchor point to the bottom, and this will make sure that the rotation of that clip goes around that axis. Animate your rotation so that the shadow stays on the same position. Make sure you add a cross dissolve on the end of the shadow clip. Then do the same thing for when your subject is landing, and here you want to fade the shadow clip in. Finally, you can also animate the exposure of your subject through Lumetri effects. When your subject is closer to the ground, he can be a little darker than when he is standing up. gonna jump back in bed to heal up for next Tuesday. Thank you guys so much for watching, thank you Premium Beat for the support, and to Janik and Lorenzo, you guys did a pretty darn creative good job.
Jordy is sick and I'm the new boss now. Let's make some new rules.
Lorenzo, start working! Faster! Move the elevating truck! Work! Work faster! You're fired, Lorenzo!
I don't even work here!
Go home!